I'm Susan with WRSU-FM, and how are you doing tonight, Heri?
I'm doing well, thanks.
I'm glad to hear it. So, just really quick, if someone had never heard Toyer before, how would you describe the music, just briefly?
It sounds like the Vikings had come back to life and found electric instruments, and eager to reclaim their place in the world.
Can you comment on something a little bit more broad and philosophical? Now, folk metal, at its core, is taking two really cool things, metal and folk music, and combining them. Now, does that make folk metal rule more than just about anything else out there?
I wouldn't say that. I mean, it's a style of music, and I like folk, I like metal, and but there's other stuff I like too. Folk has a sort of a power over people that other music, I think, doesn't. And I don't think that making that combination, metal and folk, adds anything to folk in itself. I don't think so, no.
Okay.
I mean, folk is still folk, regardless of what you make of it.
Your latest album does actually seem to include more folk influences and traditional melodies. Now, why is that? Was it just a particular direction you were going in?
Yeah, I wanted to, or we wanted to make a real folky album and use as many traditional melodies as possible, and that's what we did. And it was the thing for this album, the direction we wanted to go. And
just for a slightly broader context, as far as music, symbolism, stories go, of course you've had some false allegations of things like fascism, and
mm-hmm.
as far as the historical particulars go, what meanings do you think that this music and symbolism will take now that it's been fused into the metal culture so overtly?
I'm not sure it'll change that much. At least I hope one can de-fascistify and de-Nazify the symbols again. Because, I mean, they were there before any fascism, and they're going to be around there for a long time after. As it is at the moment, it's as you say, connected very much to metal. And as long as folk Viking metal is around, it's going to be like that. Could be that it's an impression that lasts. The metal scene isn't as well-known as, for example, fascism was once. So I'm not sure we're going to have the same impact. Could be hard to outdo the Nazis.
But you do think that your music will have a sort of educational role?
I hope so, at least. I mean, I try to point out, you know, use old, compare them to present-day situations with anything, and it's all very anti-religious, which I think is the most important message of the band. In that way, I suppose it's an attempt to be educational, yes.
Building on that very briefly, I might have my history wrong, but was it true that the Faroe Islands were never particularly touched by the Christian influences?
Oh, I'm afraid that's wrong. It's as Christianized as any part of Scandinavia, but there are some things that were forbidden elsewhere in Scandinavia, which were not forbidden in the Faroes, and pagan pre-Christian stuff that has survived in the guise of religion also. It's a Christian nation even today, I have to say, but people are not very religious, and there's a lot of respect for old tradition, and everyone knows the pre-Christian religion, and whether they like it or not, they know something about it, some more, some less.
That was just one thing that I wanted to clarify, because I did notice that some of Toyer's symbolism and themes seem somewhat resentful and rejecting of Christianity.
Yeah, we are very resentful of religion, not just Christianity. We single out Christianity because that's what we have in the Faroes, but I'm against all religion, definitely.
Is the kind of symbolism that you're promoting, is that more of a secular symbolism?
I mean, I'd have to say what in a way promote Nordic pre-Christian tradition, but I have respect for that, but I mean, I'm an atheist, and I would hope it shows in the lyrics that for example, Holy Heathen Hammerai, that even though you respect your own tradition, there's no reason to believe in anything supernatural, and I'm against all religions, and I hope that comes through in the music.
As far as the symbolism is interpreted in different contexts, I mean, you tour all over the world, and this particular symbolism, mythology, story, whatever you want to call it, is it's interpreted in many different ways, depending upon the particular context in which you travel to and promote it in. Has anything stuck out to you? Has anybody interpreted it in a very strange way? I mean, I know that there was the whole fascism controversy.
Yeah.
But other than that, was there anything else that stuck out to you?
No, not really. I mean, that's the one thing that we really came out of nowhere. We had and no clue that that was going to happen. And apart from that, I would have to say people know what we're about, people know about Nordic tradition, and some people just don't care so much about what we sing about. They just think the music's cool and they know nothing about it. Most people do. I've never come across anyone who interpreted it in a way that I wouldn't identify with, apart from that fascism thing.
Now, personally, for me, folk music was some of the first things that I ever remember hearing as a small child.
Really?
Of course, it has a very particular importance for me. Do you come from a similar position? Was folk music something that you necessarily was the first thing that you ever remember, or?
I'm not sure it was the first thing I heard ever, but very early in my life, I remember liking it. I can't say what was the first thing I heard. Probably it was something on the radio. And my mother loved ABBA, for example. Well, she still does, and I do too, because of that. My father got off the music train when Elvis became popular. Anything pre-Elvis is cool with my dad. The rest is crap, he thinks. He has. The first stuff I heard ever in my life was probably what popular music that my parents liked. It's not that common to come across Faroese traditional music. It's not that much out there as you know, pop music.
People write what they know. I was always wondering as if it, you said that people commonly come across that sort of folk music, so of course you'd write what you know.
Yeah.
Do you think that where you come from, where you're personally situated in this point in time, if you're not necessarily from Europe or from the Faroe Islands, do you think that if you identify with that, if it's not necessarily as authentic, or no matter who you are, where you are, you can identify with it?
I mean, technically there's nothing stopping anyone from identifying with anything, and there shouldn't be. For example, there could be a Scandinavian band that plays Latin American music, and everyone would think that's, a lot of people in Scandinavia would identify with that, I mean, just from liking the music, but they have nothing to do with Latin America. I've met Viking metal bands from the Middle East and Africa. Why not? I mean, it's another style of music, anyone can do it if they like. I see no problem with it. It may seem less real to some people, but to the same extent that Scandinavian Latin American music band may seem unrealistic to people of Latin America.
I don't know how versed you are in U.S. cultural affairs and whatnot, but the United States more or less pride ourselves on not being marked by what you'd call culture, any way, shape, and form, because when the colonists came here, they're more or less concerned with rejecting any previous systems, any previous ways of governing, any previous belief systems. I'm wondering why it would be that in the U.S. people would identify with this, if that's, you know, what some people in the U.S. pride themselves on, is not being marked by this culture.
There's a lot of people of Northern European and Scandinavian origin I meet in the U.S. Their parents, grandparents, or even further back were from Scandinavia or Northern Europe, and they feel in some way we represent their lost culture. And I suppose it's a very natural human feeling to want to feel connected to your roots in some way, and you can't legislate that out of people. Even though I deeply respect the American Constitution, especially about religion or non-religion, not putting a brand on people based on anything, religion, race or sex or whatever, which is quite cool. The only country in the world who has that in the Constitution.
This does, in a way, kind of come full circle, because if you say that people want to feel connected to their roots, do you think that was where the spawning of a lot of creation stories came from, and a lot of creation folklore?
Creation stories are people, everyone looks for explanations, and people unfortunately prefer crap explanations to no explanation. So a long time ago, when there was no access to any science, you could make up any story, and that would be a sufficient explanation to satisfy the curiosity of children or whoever wanted to know. But now we know where everything came from, and there's no need for religion to try to explain that anymore. It's a nice story, it's very entertaining, but that's it. It's all crap.
There is a lot of bad science out there, of course, so do you think that could come to replace religion? Because a lot of science, there's a lot of badly done science.
I don't think religion needs to be replaced, it just needs to be removed. Because there's always the feeling, and it always comes from religious circles, that what are you going to put in its place? I mean, where will morals then come from, and crap like that? As if moral ever came from religion, that's just the biggest lie in the history of humanity. There's nothing that needs to come in this place. It's like if you stop believing in Santa Claus, you don't need to put anything in this place to make your life make sense.